Raven taste, even though culturally it can be adapted, but when we talk about reading assessment or writing assessment, it was not exactly in the language of the child. It was either in English or in Hindi, when we are concerned about those sites in Hyderabad, or in Telugu. But many a times when the child is very young, the mother tongue, especially in those areas where they belong to a tribal community in Srikakulam, or those children along the borders of Karnataka and along the borders of Orissa, they don't necessarily speak Telugu, and their primary language is not Telugu. So please don't think it is, but it is, in when we do comparison of one child with another child, we did for verbal ability, we did a PPVT, Peabody Picture Vocabulary Test. For quantitative, we did cognitive development assessment. And for older cohort, we did PPVT. We dropped Raven's test because it was very, very difficult. It was very difficult to administer even to children. We have used Raven's test scores in round 2 as the base. So before we go on to understand the linkage between cognitive development and their indicators and its connection with caste and parental endowments, we should also understand what is cognitive development and achievement measurement, and what we can assign to innate ability. जो बच्चा सीखता है स्कूल में जाके या पढ़ाई के दौरान, और कुछ जो उसके अंदर की चीज़ होती है, ये इस पर बहुत ज़्यादा विवाद है. इट इज़ अ वेरी डिबेटेबल टॉपिक, बट आई मस्ट इंट्रोड्यूस इट बिफोर एवरीबडी दैट इट दिस लेवल ऑफ डिबेट इज ऑल्सो डन इज गोइंग ऑन, एंड वी हैव ट्राइड आवर लेवल बेस्ट टू account for these differences, what we can assign for cognitive development and what we can assign for innate ability. In round 1 of Young Lives, we use Raven's Color Progressive Matrices test as a measure of innate ability independent of school achievement. The Raven's test has been used to control for innate ability in studies of the effects of schooling inputs on test scores by Paul Glewy, Jacoby. In Ghana, it has already been done. I am just quoting that they have used it, so we could also, the literature supports its use, so we could use it. And then a simple family fixed effects procedure to control for the fact that Raven test also reflects the influence of children's environment. We have kind of. So test for cognitive development, what have we used? We have testing of both the PPVT and math scores shows to a certain extent that they measure cognitive skills acquired at school rather than due to innate ability. How we can come to this conclusion? Because those children who went to school, and if we compare to those children who did not go to school, the PPVT score of those children who went to school were higher across all caste, culture, across the sample. So we can safely assume, it is still an assumption, it is tested and verified technically. There is a paper that we have in Young Lives, which is written by Santiago Cueto and his team, which technically says that we can use it safely, PPVT test as measurement of cognitive. But it should not be compared. We cannot compare Indian children's scores with Peruvian children's scores because the cultural contexts are very different. But within India, we can use it as a measurement. Similarly, we can make a safe assumption that parental education gives children higher innate, it cannot give innate ability. Parents' education, we can say that if the child's family through generation is, the child is coming from an educated family background, then the child gets innate ability, but not necessarily the parents. We have not looked at grandparents or parents of grandparents or like that through the family tree. If a child belongs to a family which has been educated kind of over 100 years, we can say that it kind of affects or contributes to innate ability. But not if the parents, just the parents are educated, it does not. So these are the basic assumptions on which I will be presenting the findings. Drivers of what are the drivers of cognitive achievement, and how the inequalities are growing in education development of children. Next. If we look at the caste composition of our sample population, of these 3,000 children, we can see that in AP, the percentage, overall in state of AP, percentage of SC population is 16.2. In India, census 2001 says that 16.2 is But in our sample of these 3,000 children, 18.2% children were from SC caste. ST, we have, it is, we, our representation of ST caste, ST population is more than the average in AP and average in India, which is 6.6 and 8.1 respectively. In our sample, we have 12.8. This is also significant because ours is basically a pro-poor sample. We have taken special note of it that we select in our sample a pro-poor. And as we are seeing from this simple caste composition that when we select a pro-poor sample, we more number of SCs and STs come in our sample. Next. Now to talk about caste and especially in the light of what Professor M.N. Srinivas has written in his, when he dealt about Sanskritization process and upward mobility of caste, we should understand from our sample that it is not throwing in an element of endogeneity into it. It is the caste is completely exogenous because children don't, in our sample at least, it shows that 99.5% of children have the same caste as their mother. That means there has not been much of inter-caste marriage. And over 99% of parents share, and over 99% of children, they share the caste of their parents. Because the caste is what has been assigned at birth, it shows that 99% and 99.5%, what has been assigned at birth, it remains. So we can safely say that there is no mobility between castes. So it remains one variable which is exogenous. Average parental endowments and caste differential. As Alok was saying and all the speakers till now have said, if caste is affecting cognitive development, which are the channels through which it affects? Or it does not work through any channel. It has a direct effect. Caste has a direct effect on cognitive skill development of a child. If that happens, then the natural interpretation would be, then there is no use, there is no hope. Howsoever much you try, it lies in the genes. So a lower caste, a Dalit child or the tribal child, there is something wrong there, and there is no channel through which it operates, so there is no channel through which it can be remedied. But our findings are saying very significantly that there are definite channels through which it operates. Even though a lower caste child, a Dalit child or a tribal child scores less on cognitive development tests, but when we introduce other variables like parental education, household income, does it lower? Yes, it does lower. And then I'll say that how much does it lower? Which are those factors? Is the mother's education more important? Is the father's education more important? Is the father education more important for a SC child than one other caste child? If that, then to what degree? Is mother education more important for a girl's education, girl child's education? So these are the things which we have tried to look at. And it gets very technical. When we go into multivariate regression, it gets very technical. So I'll try my level best to present it from a very simple point of view. The results indicate a substantial and significant caste differential in average parental endowments. Like the parental education of a scheduled caste child is less than another caste child. Household income of a scheduled caste family across the board is less than household income of a family where other caste child is. The father of an SC child has on average nearly 2 years less education than an other caste father, which is 42% of a standard deviation. And a scheduled tribe father is even more disadvantaged at nearly 4 years less years of education. So this 2% and 4%, how does it translate into the cognitive development of that child. Child coming from an SC family, child coming from ST family. We'll look at it later. The differences are also stark for the mother of an ST child, as she has on an average 4 years less education, that is 87% of standard deviation, and is approximately two centimeter. We also have anthropometric measures, so we can say that she is 2 centimeter, that is 34% of a standard deviation shorter than one other caste mother. This is very significant. You may say that why are we measuring the height of mothers, but it has a bearing on, which it does correlate with the cognitive development of the child, especially those child who suffer in the earlier years. Means it is a medically proven fact now. Many studies say that a weaker or a shorter mother, I'm not saying, please don't compare India with, say, a country like Vietnam, where people are in general short. But we can compare like with like. Please don't say that in general, कहीं पे लोग छोटे ही होते हैं तो क्या उनका सेहत खराब हो जाता है? नहीं, मैं वो comparison नहीं कर रहा हूँ. Please don't compare people who are kind of like pygmies हैं. उनकी short कमी, height कमी होती हैं. जो पहाड़ पे लोग रहते हैं, जो traditionally उनकी height कम होती है. I am not comparing those. I am comparing like with like. So we have taken care of comparing like with like. So अगर माँ की हाइट कम है या उसकी सेहत खराब है, तो अगर बच्चा कमज़ोर होता है, तो फर्स्ट ईयर चाइल्ड का पहले साल का जो हेल्थ है, उसका एक कनेक्ट है, वो कोरिलेट करता है कॉग्निटिव डेवलपमेंट के साथ. देन वी फाइंड दैट पेरेंट्स एजुकेशन हैज़ ए हाईली सिग्निफिकेंट एंड पॉजिटिव इम्पैक्ट ऑन पीपीवीटी एंड मैथ्स स्कोर्स, टेस्ट स्कोर्स ऑफ चिल्ड्रेन. इट इज़ इंटरेस्टिंग to note that impact of father's education is bigger than that of mother's. If when we are comparing on educational outcomes, cognitive development. Lekin ye agar hum nutrition, baad mein we'll see in the nutrition session, this impact is, the mother's education is more important, is more significant when we see the nutrition outcomes. But when we see the education outcomes, father's education is bigger than mother's. Further, the impact of parents' education is greater for PPVT scores than for math scores. I'm not sure how to interpret this result, but this is a result which we are getting. Parent ka education PPVT score ke saath zyada correlate karta hai, math score ke saath utna zyada nahi. Ya usme bahut sari baatein ho sakti hain. Ho sakta hai school mein maths ki padhai achhi hoti hogi, इसलिए वो पेरेंट्स के एजुकेशन के साथ कम कोरिलेट करता है, यानी कि उसको स्कूल में जो एजुकेशन मिल रहा है वो, या नहीं तो लैंग्वेज के डेवलपमेंट और मैथ स्किल्स के डेवलपमेंट में कुछ खास ऐसी बात होती होगी. द एजुकेशनिस्ट कैन टेल बेटर, जो कुछ खास ऐसी बातें होती होंगी कि वो पेरेंट्स के एजुकेशन के साथ नहीं रिलेट करता है, या नहीं तो जो जिस ग्रुप, एज ग्रुप के बच्चों को हम देख रहे हैं, हु वर 5 ईयर ओल्ड एंड 12 ईयर ओल्ड रिस्पेक्टिवली इन सेकेंड राउंड, उनमें इस तरह की बात खास देखी जाती है. दिस इज जस्ट अ रिजल्ट, आई एम नॉट इंटरप्रेटिंग इट इन एनी वे. द कोएफिशिएंट ऑन वेल्थ इंडेक्स ऑफ द हाउस होल्ड इज पॉजिटिव एंड सिग्निफिकेंट फॉर बोथ टेस्ट. वेल्थ इंडेक्स, जिस फैमिली का वेल्थ इंडेक्स ज़्यादा है वहाँ पे स्कोर्स ज़्यादा हैं, ये नॉर्मल सी बात है. Boys do better on PPVT and maths test by approximately 3 and 0.2 points respectively. So boys दोनों ही type के test पे ज़्यादा score करते हैं, लेकिन PPVT में ज़्यादा करते हैं, यानी कि vocabulary test में, receptive vocabulary का जो test है उसमें ज़्यादा gap आता है. Maths में boys और girls में difference कम आता है, जो कि आम मान्यता, आम धारणा के खिलाफ है. It is against what we naturally or have been believing over the years, that girls are, women are weaker at maths. But this is what is scientifically we are getting. Now, when any of these factors are combined, for example, like Alok was also talking about multiple deprivation. जैसे एक rural area में है, low educated parent है, तो और minority language भी वो बच्चा बोलता है, तो gap ज़्यादा बड़ा हो जाता है. The findings also show that these inequalities, especially parental education and rural-urban factors, have even greater impact on older children than younger children. उससे क्या पता चल रहा है कि अगर जो डेप्रिवेशन है जो बर्थ के साथ कास्ट असाइन हो गया है, तो जैसे जैसे वो समय बढ़ता जाएगा, जैसे जैसे बच्चा बड़ा होता जाएगा, वो उसका इफेक्ट ज्यादा होता रहेगा। मतलब अगर आप छोटे बच्चे को देखेंगे तो एक अदर कास्ट के बच्चे और एक शेड्यूल कास्ट के बच्चे में बहुत कम डिफरेंस होगा, लेकिन जैसे समय बढ़ेगा, अगर वो आप पांचवी कक्षा पांचवी क्लास की बात कर रहे हैं और वो दसवीं क्लास में बात करेंगे, तो जो एक अदर कास्ट का एक बच्चा है और शेड्यूल कास्ट का बच्चा है, वो गैप बड़ा हो जाता है। शुरू में वो कम दिखता है, बाद में, अभी सिंस वी हैव ओनली टू राउंड्स ऑफ डेटा, वी कैन वेल मोर ऑन इट व्हेन वी हैव राउंड थ्री डेटा। इस बारी जब हम फील्ड में जाएंगे तो वही बच्चे जो पाँच साल के थे वो आठ साल के हो जाएंगे, और ये बारह साल वाले पंद्रह साल के हो जाएंगे, तो हमें और भी ज़्यादा देखने को मिलेगा। नाउ वी कैन से पीपीवीटी स्कोर्स और कास्ट के बीच में क्या एग्जैक्ट रिलेशन है। द पीपीवीटी रिजल्ट्स इंडिकेट अ रोबस्ट इफेक्ट ऑफ कास्ट इन द इनिशियल स्पेसिफिकेशन, दैट इज बीइंग एन एससी चाइल्ड इज एसोसिएटेड विथ 31% ऑफ ए स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन लोअर लॉग पीपीवीटी स्कोर। मतलब अगर आप बच्चा एससी फैमिली से आता है, शेड्यूल कास्ट को बिलोंग करता है, तो वो लोअर स्कोर करता है, लेकिन दिस इफेक्ट डिसअपियर्स ऑलमोस्ट इंटायरली इन द सब्सिक्वेंट स्पेसिफिकेशन एंड सीम्स टू बी ऑलमोस्ट इंटायरली चैनल्ड थ्रू पैरेंटल एजुकेशन एंड हाउस होल्ड सोशियो इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस। अगर हम इन दो सोशियो इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस और पैरेंटल एजुकेशन के फैक्टर को भी लाते हैं, तो हमें पता चलता है कि वो डायरेक्ट नहीं है, इनके थ्रू चैनल होता है। पैरेंटल एजुकेशन एंड सोशियो इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस अपीयर टू बी हाईली सिग्निफिकेंट इफ देर इज वन ईयर इंक्रीज इन फादर्स एजुकेशन, इट इज एसोसिएटेड विथ अ 2% ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इन लॉग पीपीवीटी स्कोर। अगर एक बच्चे का के फादर का एक साल का एजुकेशन बढ़ जाता है, तो बच्चे का जो पीपीवीटी स्कोर है वो 2% ऑफ ए स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन बढ़ जाता है। और अगर स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन एंड स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इंक्रीज इन वेल्थ इंडेक्स, अगर एक स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन बढ़ता है वेल्थ इंडेक्स पे, तो स्कोर 12% स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन पे बढ़ जाता है बच्चे का। सो इट हैज अ बिग इफेक्ट।
और आई होप सम ऑफ आर देयर फ्रॉम एकेडमिक बैकग्राउंड, बट सम आर प्रोबब्ली outside academy, so it would be helpful if you side by side just explain briefly as to what it is. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Alok. I lost my track. I'm sorry. Parental education or socio-economic status. Parental education का मतलब है कि जो माँ और पिता हैं वो कितना पढ़े हैं। अगर हम ये देखते हैं कि एक बच्चा दो सेट ऑफ एक बच्चा और दो बच्चे को हम कंपेयर नहीं कर सकते हैं स्टैटिस्टिकल एनालिसिस में। दो सेट है बच्चे का, स्टैटिस्टिकली सिग्निफिकेंट नंबर होना चाहिए, दो सेट है। एक सेट है बच्चे का जिसमें जो दूसरे सेट में पेरेंट्स का एजुकेशन अगर एक साल बढ़ता है, एक सेट में मान लीजिए हमारा सात साल की पढ़ाई करी है और दूसरे में अगर आठ साल की पढ़ाई करी है, तो दोनों सेट के जो बच्चे हैं उसमें आप 2% स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन देखिएगा, यानी कि जो काफ़ी बड़ा चेंज हो जाता है एक साल के अंतर से। और वेल्थ इंडेक्स में अगर एक स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन का चेंज हो जाता है, यानी कि थोड़ा सा फैमिली ज़्यादा रिच हुई, तो उसका जो स्कोर है वो 12% स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन से बढ़ जाता है, यानी कि एक थोड़े से ज़्यादा बढ़ जाता है। अब वो इंटरप्लेस कास्ट के अंदर कैसा है, ये इसको अगर लेंगे तो वो कास्ट के अंदर है, वो हम आगे देखने की कोशिश करेंगे। लेकिन यहाँ पर एक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि चाइल्ड हेल्थ प्रायर टू द एज ऑफ वन इज आल्सो सिग्निफिकेंट बट हैज़ ए स्मॉलर इम्पैक्ट एंड पैरेंटल साइको सोशल कॉम्पिटेंसीज डू नॉट सीम टू बी सिग्निफिकेंट। इट इज चाइल्ड हेल्थ बहुत सिग्निफिकेंट है, लेकिन पैरेंटल साइको सोशल कॉम्पिटेंसीज जो है वो बहुत ज़्यादा इफेक्ट नहीं कर रहा है। पर ध्यान रखने की बात यह है कि वी आर ओनली लुकिंग एट वेरी यंग चाइल्ड। This may have more effect as the child grows. Parents' psychosocial competencies may impact cognitive skill development of the child when the child is older, which our results in round 3 will tell us more about it. Now we see cognitive development scores and caste. It tells a similar story, but it has वो अ लिटिल डिफरेंस इज द रेसिडुअल इफेक्ट। पार्डन, the little difference is in the residual effect. Like, wo jo channel hai, parental endowments ka aur household income ka, to agar hum wo do factor laate hai, to PPVT score jo correlate karta tha caste ke saath, wo bahut kam ho jata tha. Lekin ye effect reh jata hai agar hum cognitive development assessment scores ki baat karte hai. Yani ki thoda sa yahan pe zyada intergenerational ki baat aa rahi hai, wo zyada effect hai. Also, the role of parental psychosocial competency seems to be significant, but as we have already said. So I'll next come to which are the channels, cognitive scores and caste. Which are the channels? The results indicate that caste plays a significant role in the early age development of cognitive skills, with scheduled caste and scheduled tribe children showing lower cognitive achievements than children from the other castes. SC, ST children seem to, on an average, have less educated parents, come from households with lower socioeconomic status, and have lower initial health outcomes in general. The caste effect on the development of cognitive skills is channeled largely through lower parental education, lower household socioeconomic status, with a limited role for the child's initial health outcomes. The results thus seem to suggest intergenerational transmission of outcomes. That is, scheduled caste and scheduled tribe children have, on an average, less educated and less well-off parents, which negatively impacts the development of cognitive skills in childhood. And this, in turn, harms the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe child's prospects in school and puts him or her on a lower educational trajectory. Now, we'll see as we have longitudinal data, what value does it add to our understanding? How much more can we learn? We can subsequently trace the extent to which this initial cognitive skill gap translates into school achievement gap by caste. Since in round two, these children were 8 and 12, now these children will be 12 and 15 respectively. And when we go to the field again in 2009 and 2015, we can trace how the gap is increasing or decreasing, which are other factors coming into play. The lower socioeconomic status of scheduled caste and scheduled tribe parents may not enable them to send their children to private schools. So a schooling, type of schooling, quality of schooling is also a factor, which we already see in sample. Or the lack of educated parents could make SCST child to have an inferior learning environment at home. As learning is cumulative, a child who has fallen behind in initial years may have to face increasing levels of difficulty catching up in later years, which the caste-based discrimination in school may exacerbate this gap. The probe report, which had come out in 1999, had extensively documented discrimination of SCST children by teachers and treatment of. So we can see this how. The probe report, the second round probe report has also come. It has not been shared publicly, I suppose. So we'll have to wait for another 1 month or so. They have gone to the field again in 5 states, and probe 2 report has also come. So we'll get to know more about it. Now, what are the policy implications? What are the questions that we are posing to ourselves and policy makers? Is there a significant correlation in the initial cognitive skills of the child and their performance in school? So we yet have to understand that. And further, is there evidence that government policies targeting children in lower primary school can redress some of the inequities caused by the differential in cognitive skills? This is something which we have to understand more. And if subsequent data for this sample indicates that the answer to these questions is in the affirmative, अगर हमको ये पता चलता है कि हाँ इस तरह के रिलेशनशिप हैं, then there is a strong policy case for aggressively targeting resources for scheduled caste and scheduled tribe children at the primary and lower. Strong case बनता है, but हम आगे अगर पेपर में देखेंगे तो जो हाल है हमारा एजुकेशन के बजट का, तो एक तो एलोकेशन कम होता है उसके ऊपर से under expenditure bahut zyada. In 2006-07, under expenditure was for those programs which were meant for quality education were to the magnitude of around 38.66%, and scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, Muslims, religious minorities. So we see that the maximum under expenditure is for programs specially for promoting equity in education. 48% over a year, over a period of 3 years, 4, 5 to 6, 7, 48% of the funds which were meant for the schemes targeted at these excluded groups were unspent. Now we went into some detail jin mein zyada under expenditure tha. So madrasa education ke modernization ke liye jo fund tha wo pura ka pura hi aisa hi pada reh gaya, kuch bhi kharch nahi hua. Area intensive program for educational backward minorities, isme bhi 100% under expenditure hai. Strengthening of linguistic minority education by supplying teaching learning materials to upper primary school and high schools, pura ka pura aisa hi rakha reh gaya, kuch bhi nahi kharch hua. Book bank for scheduled caste, 90% se zyada under expenditure hai. Major work, building, major works, jo major works matlab naye constructions hai, minor works matlab repair hota hai, ye sarkar ki apni bhasha hai, wahan pe bhi 90% se zyada paisa rakha reh gaya. To hum ye sochte hain ki kya state jo inequities hai jo over the year transmit hote hue aa rahi hai usko address karne ka kaam kya state ka nahi hai, jo household level pe jo inequalities hai, should the state not play any.
Main isko summarize karne ki koshish kar raha hu, par jaise ki aap dekhe honge throughout his presentation that and I think what Ajay has done is has given a or rather has thrown a large number of questions to all of us with regard to how are social norms revolving around the age-old practices and sustaining them and therefore impacting in the way we access opportunities, and in this particular case agar our opportunities are essentially directed towards development, or in this case if we look at education as one driver of change or ek mauka jo hamare bachchon ko aur samaj ko badalne ki koshish kar raha hai, usme kaun se varg ke log किस तरह के मौके को हासिल कर पा रहे हैं या फिर किस तरह की स्थिति में हैं जिससे उनके जो अगला जनरेशन है, उनके जो बच्चे हैं और उसके बाद उनके जो बच्चे हैं, जो जनरेशन आफ्टर जनरेशन जो इनइक्वालिटी बनता जाता है, बढ़ता जाता है और सस्टेन होता जा रहा है. तो मुद्दा आप समझ गए होंगे कि अगर पेरेंट्स का बैकग्राउंड मजबूत नहीं है, और मजबूती का यहाँ ये संदर्भ में मतलब होता है अगर उनकी सामाजिक स्थिति और आर्थिक स्थिति मजबूत नहीं है तो उनके बच्चे भी उसी उसी तरह की स्थिति से गुजरेंगे जो वो गुजरे हैं. तो ये एक साइकिल और एक विशियस साइकिल ऑफ डिप्राइवेशन और मार्जिनलाइजेशन जो बनता जा रहा है. नाउ अगर हम ये कह रहे हैं कि जो एससी और एसटी के बच्चे, और खासकर हम बाकी वर्गों को यहाँ देखे नहीं हैं, पर बाकी भी वर्ग हैं जो उतने ही बिछड़े हुए हैं, और इनके बैकग्राउंड से अगर ये देखेंगे कि अगर उनका शिक्षा नहीं हो और उनके पास उस तरह का आर्थिक स्थिति नहीं हो तो उनके बच्चे ज़्यादा कम एजुकेशन का स्टेटस हासिल करेंगे या फिर लर्निंग हासिल करेंगे, और उनका दिमागी विकास जो है उतना ही लिमिटेड होगा जो कॉग्निटिव डेवलपमेंट की बात हम कर रहे हैं. तो उसमें वो पेरेंट्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल नहीं है. पेरेंट्स कम एजुकेटेड होना या फिर कम आर्थिक स्थिति होना उनका खुद का निर्णय नहीं था. उनका खुद का जो जो स्थिति होती है वो उनके खुद के क्रिएट किए हुए स्थिति नहीं है। तो अजय जो प्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं वो बहुत ही सिग्निफिकेंट है इस संदर्भ में कि अगर हम फिर उसके अंदर जाने की कोशिश करें, झांकने की कोशिश करें, क्यों ऐसे जनरेशन के बाद जनरेशन, जनरेशन के बाद जनरेशन सिर्फ इसी वर्ग के लोग या बच्चे उतने ही कम कॉग्निटिव डेवलपमेंट में गुजर रहे हैं। एक उदाहरण जो मैं दोहराना चाहूँगा, उन्होंने कहा कि लड़के के कंपैरिजन में लड़की को ज़्यादा नुकसान होता है एजुकेशन ईयर्स का, तकरीबन 4 साल का, और एक लड़का 2 साल लूज करता है जबकि एक लड़की 4 साल लूज करती है उसमें शिक्षा। क्यों करती है? अगर उनके बैकग्राउंड, उनके पेरेंट्स के बैकग्राउंड सामाजिक और आर्थिक तरीके से खराब हो या फिर कमज़ोर हो, और सामाजिक यहाँ मतलब कम शिक्षा होना या फिर कम स्वास्थ्य की स्थिति होना, जो जो हाइट की बात वो कर रहे थे, इस कास्ट के साथ कोरिलेट करता है ना। ये सिग्निफिकेंट इसलिए है कि क्यों कास्ट के साथ रिलेट करता है, क्योंकि हम कास्ट को ऐसे देखे हैं कि जो डिटरमिन करता है कि किसको क्या मौका मिलना चाहिए, और ये समाज के जो नॉर्म्स हैं, ये जो सोशल नॉर्म्स हैं, इसको हमारा जो पॉलिसी का एनवायरनमेंट है, जो सरकार की नीतियां हैं, वो बहुत ही प्रोग्रेसिव नीतियां हैं। हमारा संविधान भी उतना प्रोग्रेसिव संविधान है, प्रोग्राम्स भी वैसे, स्कीम्स भी वैसे सरकार ने बनाया हुआ जो ये, तो इसको कैसे वो उसको कैसे वो इम्पैक्ट करता है वो ये बताने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं। तो हमको इसमें 2-3 चीज़ें मोटे मोटे तौर पे आप ध्यान में रखिएगा। अभी जयदीप जो इसको विस्तार से बात करेंगे उसको हम फिर उसे जोड़ने की कोशिश करेंगे कि सोशल नॉर्म्स, गवर्नेंस, सो देयरफॉर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड द पॉलिसी एनवायरनमेंट मिलके कैसे हमारे बच्चों को अपने अधिकार से वंचित रखते हैं और उनको एक्सक्लूडेड रहने में भूमिका निभा रहे हैं।